we're back and welcome back to the 700 Club. I got to tell you how tacky I am. Normally I have water here. I brought my juice.
And that's the brain's formula.
This is the brain formula.
Your brain's going to be just running 100 miles an hour.
Exploding with knowledge, Pat.
Really
exploding.
Wide. Okay.
Speaking of that, let's jump into Bring It On with Camelia. And she says, Pat, my friend told me it's not good to eat grapefruit with medicines, but they couldn't remember the reason. Why is it bad to have medicine and grapefruit together?
Well, apparently what happens is that the grapefruit will take your inner processes, your liver and so forth, and get it all occupied. And while that happens, these medicines will go through without being processed properly, and they can hit you really hard.
Oh, wow.
So it can cause toxic reactions. So things like amiodarone and stuff like that. So that's what it's all about. And the warning label is stay away from grapefruit. And this is at least a 12-hour deal or a 24-hour deal. So it's I love grapefruit and grapefruit juice, but and I didn't realize how toxic that became, but it does.
Yeah, I had no clue. That's good to know.
Yeah,
all right, Sarah writes in, and Sarah says, my 39-year-old husband comes home from work every night and watches TV or sits at the computer until bedtime. He's not motivated to exercise at all, and this concerns me. How can I encourage an unmotivated spouse to work out?
I think I'd get a casket and put it in the bedroom and show him what he's going to be. You know, see, if you're
subtle,
really,
Pat, subtle.
Yeah, you got to hit the guy like that over the head. And, you know, you say, honey, if you love me and the children, I want you to stay alive a little longer, and this is going to kill you. And that's the first thing. The second thing would be to say, well, let's go for a bicycle ride, or let's take a walk. You know, just come on, honey, walk around the block with me. Not a big deal. Just let's walk around the block, you know, and look at the flowers, or look at the leaves in the fall, or what have you. And maybe breathing the fresh air might get to him. But what happens is that you're tired from work, and so you sit down because you don't want to do anything, and then the longer you watch TV, the tireder you get, so it's a vicious cycle. Then he goes to bed, and he wakes up, and he's dragged out. So maybe you can figure out some vacation where you can go and you can do canoeing or do a whitewater raft trip or something, and or ride a horse or ride a bicycle or do something that's kind of fun and doesn't sound like it's exercise. And before long, maybe you can get him going. But I'd shock him. See, if you really love me, you won't die early, please, because, you know, I need you. You don't have enough insurance to take care of me.
All right, well. Pat, every time I feel like you have just, I've heard the answers, this and that, you shock me.
Well, all right.
The casket in the living room. God bless
you. That would work, don't you think?
It would work for me. All right. Phil writes in and says, my kids had some ice cream the other night after dinner, and they were bouncing off the walls until 11 p.m. What is it about sugar that makes children and people so hyperactive?
Well, it just stimulates the adrenal glands and gets you going. I mean, it does, especially if you haven't had much of it. But you really need to lay off of sugar. Now, I think these so-called excitotoxins, that these artificial sweeteners have more danger than sugar itself.
Mm-hmm.
But a little bit of sugar is not going to do that, but a lot of it can.
Mm-hmm. I remember listening to one doctor, one study, say that sugar has absolutely no impact on children whatsoever. And
that's,
I was like, yeah,
nonsense.
You have no children.
Nonsense.
It is.
Oh, sure.
I totally agree. If I give my son a cookie, man, he's just running loops around the house.
Right.
Literally. All right. Flora writes and says, Pat, I know it's good to get plenty of antioxidants to combat the free radicals in our bodies, but what foods would you recommend for getting plenty of antioxidants in your diet?
Well, as far as fruit, the name of the game is the dark-colored fruit are loaded with, I mean, blueberries, strawberries, things like that. Same thing with vegetables. The deep-colored ones seem to have more of the phytochemicals, which, you know, have the antioxidants in it. But fruit and vegetables is where the action is.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where you go.
There you go.
Right.
And especially what we learned today about the juicing. Take all those things and juice it up.
Juice it up.
You'll be good
Absolutely.
To go.
All right.
All right. Carter writes in and says, I've been obese for most of my life, and now I think I'm ready to do something about it. What's the best way for someone to get started who's large and out of shape? Should I start out strong with long, hard workouts like they do on the TV show The Biggest Loser?
Carter, those guys work out in an insane fashion in order to lose that weight. I mean, they go several hours a day.
4 hours a day, Pat.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's awful and punishing. So
mm-hmm.
The first thing you got to do is get a complete physical. If you're overweight, you die of a stroke. So you make sure that your blood vessels are clear and that you don't have hypertension and some of these things. And unless you're cleared by a doctor, you're real heavy, you start working, you kill yourself. Mm-hmm. So the next thing is to start off slow. Slow walking, just walk. Walk is great exercise. So you could, maybe all you can do is walk around the block. And then the next thing you know, you walk maybe a half a mile. Then you walk a mile. Then before long, you're jogging. And you build it up. And then you get some light weights and begin to build up your muscle tone. It takes a while, but don't just leap into it and don't think you've got to start 100 miles an hour like the Biggest Loser. I mean, they're on a time clock. They've got to get that fat off those people, and they're going to work them to death. Now, if you've got some time and you could, make believe you're in a boot camp, you can go ahead and do it. But it isn't advisable.
Absolutely. And that's great advice, Pat, because people need to realize you didn't get heavy in a day.
That's
you're not
right.
going to lose it in a day. Give yourself some time.